Okay, folks, welcome to the Winogrand Circus. This is my friend Garry Winogrand, and he's going to explain all his pictures.
No, wait a minute.
I wonder what's if anybody has anything on their minds or whatever. I mean, I'm going to pass the ball back to you. The photography, considering the nature of the medium, has been lucky. I mean, there's been you can make a good list of really great artists, by any standards. Forget about the great people. There's great work. The hell with the people. Really, it comes down to.
Garry,
and then I could make a big list if I really gave it. Deanne, like I say, Cortez, Ache, Brassai. At least in terms of my experience, Evans's work was radically different. Evans is a very special photographer. You study his work. He's probably for my money, he's probably the most transparent photographer. The only other one who would I would say that about is Ache, and Ache's work winds up being characterized by the materials he used in terms of his time. In the end, he doesn't completely get out of the way, but Evans, more than anybody else, gets out of the way. It's as close to the absence of an obvious strategy that I know of.
Do you strive for that transparent quality, for being transparent?
I don't know, I'm stuck with me, whatever. I really can't answer it. I know when I see what I see. And so I would like not to exist. I don't know how that works. Do I make sense to you? I would like not to exist. Leave it at that. I'm not speaking in mysteries. Really. I mean.
You mean you wouldn't want to make? You don't want to make choices?
Oh, that I never do. All I do is say yes. That's.
One thing that's always puzzled me, really, is what it is about Robert Frank that had the enormous impact on you, and I've never been able to fathom that exactly. Not saying that he isn't a terrific photographer, but why, the almost godlike status of Frank?
The work is great. It's great work. It's great work.
It seems
and
to be the least transparent, that he really took a lot of cheap shots.
I wouldn't use the word cheap so easy.
Well, I'm trying to get you to tell me what, for example, there was for you that was so important.
I don't know, for me, the way you asked the question, I can talk about it in terms of me. All right? For me, the American photographs of Evans, it zonked me. It really killed me. And I didn't understand it at all. I saw something, and I did know that that's what I got to learn from. I was going to take a trip around the country, and somebody told me you should see that book. And I knew something happened to me when I saw that work. I never heard of the guy. I never heard of Walker Evans. But then the Frank book showed up, and really, I think the most immediate lesson I could get from the Frank book, from the Americans, was camera operation. I'll tell you something. See, I took my trip, and there's a picture in the Frank book of a statue. I think of St. Augustine or something
In Los Angeles.
In Los Angeles. It's really at the very end of Sunset Boulevard, the downtown end of it, where it ends. You know that statue?
Sure. It's right there.
Now, see, when I took my trip in 55, I had seen this... the Evans stuff. I took a picture. I shot that goddamn statue. I made a reasonably good picture of it. It was a thing. And I saw the Frank book. He got that picture, and it killed me. It killed it. Put me away six ways. What the hell? I mean, you better face the fact. If you don't face the fact, you're never going to learn a goddamn thing. But it did. It was, and. The picture I made was made, and the picture he made happened. It went whoosh right across the page. It didn't make any attempt at hitting over and making any points. It may not be a great picture, but to me it is, because it taught me a hell, right off the bat, boom. Do you remember that a couple of weeks ago, I shot a football game at Rice at night? And some kid, I think he's a student at Rice, was photographing. He may have been photographing for a local newspaper, whatever. And he says, Jesus, last year the action was much more exciting. And I said to the kid, you know, in the end, I said to the kid, it's only pictures we're getting. You know, you don't know the difference from the pictures. I've been shooting a lot of football, and I'm trying to make interesting pictures of the action itself. You know, and that's more interesting to me than trying to make interesting pictures of whatever, of a cheerleader, you know, whatever. Which is interesting. Terribly interesting. But, see what I'm trying to say? You're dealing with subject matter that is inherently, in itself, more dramatic. And consequently, it makes the problem of making an interesting photograph more difficult or more interesting. How do you make a photograph that's more interesting than what happened? That's really the problem.
But do you think of it?
You know, when you photograph something beautiful, how do you make a photograph that's more beautiful than what was photographed? That's really our problem in the end. In the end, the word dramatic has to apply. It's always about that. Is the photograph more dramatic than what was photographed? It has to be. I think you know, photographs or anything or any works of art that have any real power, play with your, first of all, they play with what you think you know. They make you question what you think you know. Well, let's put it this way, make you question your preconceptions. What do you know from a photograph? They don't have narrative ability. The interesting thing is, I mean, there's a seeming paradox functioning. They're not ambiguous. There's nothing ambiguous about any of these photographs, yet you don't know what's happening. Well, ambiguous, is almost the opposite of being specific. These things are very specific.
I have a question on when you tilt your frame, you think...
I never tilted.
You don't tilt? Are you just tilting?
There's no tilts. Show me a tilt. No, that's not tilted.
That's not tilted.
All right, I'm playing.
Got you.
I'm playing. But seriously, it's not. Let's say, certainly it's tilted if one insists. You say you're arbitrarily deciding that the horizontal edge is the point of reference, and the horizon should be parallel.
Right.
But I can arbitrarily decide that the vertical edge is the point of reference.
Did anybody actually teach, do anything to teach you how to do that? I mean, I'm not talking about their photographs.
Yeah.
You mentioned Evans and Franklin. Did anybody actually serve as a teacher, even in a very minor role for you?
Sorry. Just work. That's really it. You know, you bounce off that. The technique is easy. Photographic technique is simple. It really is. But the whole process, it's a very forgiving process. You can make a lot of errors and still wind up with a printable negative. Am I right? You'd have to really grossly overexpose or underexpose or overdevelop or underexpose or combinations, whatever, to get an unprintable negative. So the technique is easy. Even when you goof, it's only, what is it? You goof for a roll or you goof for half a roll? You know what I'm talking about. It ain't the end of the world. I really don't think you really learn from teachers. You learn from work. And I think what you learn really is how to be, and you have to be your own toughest critic. And you only learn that from work, from seeing work. Let's call it intelligent work. And it gets more complicated than that. We all have limitations. At any given time, we're limited. And you can only learn from what you can understand at a given time. Hopefully, you learn something so you understand more. And on that level, you're a critic. You're your own critic. To make the point, I think every photographer who does any reasonable amount of work discovers at times, if they look at an old contact sheets, frames they never conceived of printing when they first shot it.
So you think you also have an interest in the things you think?
Oh, sure. I have no doubt about it. Come on. Whatever that interest is, it varies from thing to thing. You know, and then the women, let's say with the women pictures, from one to the next, the interest can be different.
But you're interested in women. And say,
I'm not interested. Come on, interested in women. What does that mean? I mean, I'm married. I'm interested in my wife. I'm curious about her. You know, I mean, you could say I'm interested in women. How? In some pictures, I could be interested in a physical attitude. And in another picture, I could be interested. What I mean by a physical attitude is, you know, the reason I made a photograph of the woman is how she moved. Of course. Of course. I mean, obviously. Well, certainly, you can't call Los Angeles urban.
You can't.
Anybody who calls Los Angeles urban doesn't know what it's like there. No, Los Angeles is more like Irving. No, it's not. Certainly not urban. You know, New York City is urban. Chicago can be urban. Los Angeles doesn't happen that way. San Francisco doesn't interest me as much. It's the scene there is strange to me. You know, let me put it this way: in a certain sense, the person from San Francisco feels competitive with New York culturally. They're like culture vultures, which the way New Yorkers are never are. They're concerned with culture with a capital C, like it's a thing. It's not like it's a part of life. It's something you put in your pocket and take, you know, whatever. But they think of it that way, and competitively with New York, the people in Los Angeles don't give a shit. You know, they couldn't care less about New York or what. They got their own. They're the way they are. It's much more interesting, yeah. For me. So that's the only way I can put it. You know.
Question is, are you willing to sort of peel the subject and throw it away?
If I take the picture, who needs it? I mean, I don't have anything to do with what I photograph. I make a shot, I'm gone. I'm keeping my eyes open. I don't know what's going to happen next. Seriously, I mean, that's it. I don't have any. I'm not running for mayor. I don't get to know people when I'm photographing. I'm not. You know. I mean, I'm tough in my own way. The last time I got to know anybody, I got my knee busted. You know? Okay. So.
Read two or three people or heard two or three people like they say about photographic shows of yours that you were a bad editor.
Ah, that's horseshit. You know, I know who those people are, but I'm a good editor.
Did you select the pictures for the book Public Relations?
No.
What do you think? Do you like the idea of turning the selection over to someone else?
Well, no, I wasn't out of it, really. I mean, Todd made a trip to New York, to Texas, and we did some work together. Todd was the curator, you know, the guest curator on the show, and this fellow Tom Consilvio printed it for me. I like to say, Todd edited, Tom cropped it. No, I have my. It's a joke. I mean, whether it makes sense to you or not, I don't deal with these things. Not like my life depends on it. And I just figure the hell with it. I learned a long time ago that I just go ahead and do it. And then I close the door on it because I know that that's the way I function. And I don't deal with these things like they're masterpieces. I deal with them in terms of what I'm interested in at a given moment, really. And I could look at a picture and I could be interested in it for this reason or that reason. I indulge myself that way. I learned a long time ago, there's no one show or selection that's going to be fatal or going to send me heaven bound, you know, one way or the other. You know what I mean? It's not all that serious. I don't deal with it that way. I never have. You see that? You see that? Another masterpiece bites the dust, you see? Yeah.